Okay. Well, it was awesome. We had Rakefet Abigail, who's an Israeli lesbian comedian. Elijah Kelly from Hairspray, who has a huge movie coming out in May. He did George Lucas's new movie. And we also have Pini Benzaken, who is a hairdresser to the stars. And we just exploded. And next week we have Shelby Jones, Marty Ingalls, Noah Tishby. So the radio show is going really well.
When did you start doing it?
2 months ago.
So how did you snag this? I mean, you're the only English language show on there, so how did you get that?
How did I get that? Yeah. I just told them that's what I wanted to do. Yeah. I was a guest on the radio show a few times promoting my parties, yeah. And I guess I was a good guest, and they liked me, so show came in from it.
Oh, cool. So you've booked a lot of very recognizable names.
Yeah, I know a lot of people, so I know I have a lot of celebrity friends and a lot of people in the industry and stuff like that, so they're more than willing to come on.
So you've got Shirley Jones coming on next week?
Yes.
And her husband?
And her husband, and if Shirley gets a word in edgewise, I'll be amazed.
Does he still host a radio show himself?
No, he used to.
Yeah.
But it is very crazy, and yeah. You know, you're going to see Mother Partridge like you've never seen her before. They're very different than, they're very cool people.
So, where did you grow up?
That's a story that you heard of the term Wandering Jew.
Yeah.
So, that's what I was. I went to 4 high schools and 2 junior high schools. I was born in Oklahoma on an army base. My father was in the army. And my parents conceived me in New York, and I grew up partly in New York City, partly in New Jersey, partly in Boston, all over.
And do you want a Diet Coke or a Diet 7-Up or water?
7-Up.
Okay, hang on a sec.
What do you start and splice it together?
Doesn't matter.
Thanks.
And I've got water if you need it, or Diet Coke. So that's got antioxidants. It's cherry flavored, it looks like. Hey.
I've never had it before, so I'm into trying new things.
So try
thank
it and
you,
tell us what it's like.
Okay, if the Diet 7-Up people are listening, good stuff. I'll do a commercial for you.
So how much of your childhood did you spend in Israel?
I didn't. When I moved to Boston, I moved to a small town called Andover, and now there are Jews there. Now they built a temple, but there wasn't when I was there, and I faced a lot of anti-Semitism. And I mean, my parents, I was bar mitzvahed and stuff, but we were very non-religious, and I didn't realize I was Jewish so much until I moved there, and people told me I was Jewish because people beat me up for it.
Right.
I had a history teacher that refused to teach me because I didn't believe in Jesus. So it was fun stuff. And then my parents realized what was going on, so they sent me USY on Wheels, which is a conservative youth group across the country. And then I had to do the tefillin and all that stuff, and I never saw that in my life. So it was an interesting experience. It woke me up a little. Became kosher for a little bit, then became a vegetarian, which I am till today, a vegetarian for 30 years. And that's it. You know, I awakened the Jew in me, and then I went to Israel, and then I fell in love with it. I said, this is my country. So.
For some reason, I'm kind of seeing Borat. Like, you're talking about USY on wheels. Like,
It was a whole new experience for me. I mean, you go cross country and you pray in the open, and people look at you when you put on the tefillin and pray, and you pray. It was very religious for me, and part of me felt like an outsider. Part of me felt like, wow, this is cool. We're like ambassadors for Jewishness.
Right.
And people like in Iowa or Kansas, people were just like staring at us.
Right.
It was kind of interesting, you know? I think it's a very good experience, especially for someone like me that wasn't raised that way, and it made me aware of who I am. I think it became a big part of me, you know, actually my parents blame that for brainwashing me and making me move to Israel. So it was very interesting. My parents thought I was brainwashed. No, I'm joking. But
did you have siblings?
Yeah, I have a sister, and she lives in Colorado. She has two kids, and she's married to a non-Jew, and I'm the one that named them the Jewish names. And it's funny because the last name is Nun, and you see the kids and they don't look anything Jewish, and I'm like the Jewish uncle.
Are you the youngest or the oldest?
I'm the oldest.
Okay. What was your parents' relationship with Jewishness?
My mom came from a semi-religious family. My grandparents were kosher and kept kosher, and they were religious. And my father's interesting. His parents escaped the Holocaust in 1937, and my grandmother came to the States when she was 5 or 6 months pregnant with my father. And my father was born early. My father's first language is German, and to this day he refuses to speak it. And oh, it's funny because we were never. My grandmother tried to teach me German, and I wasn't. There was huge fights in the family because of it. And I remember when we bought the Rocket 99 Luftballons by Nina.
Yeah, yeah.
My father broke it in half. We played the German side. It was kind of cool. So it was an interesting childhood.
Huh. And how did that affect you moving around so much as a kid?
As a kid, I hated it because sometimes I just didn't feel like making new friends. Because you picked up and you moved to different places. Some places I liked more than others. But like in Massachusetts, I really hated it. And my only friends were black. They had no black people in my town. So the state mandated that they import them. So there's a program called ABC, A Better Chance, and they took the top kids from Chicago and Indiana and North Carolina and put them in a house and had social workers, and those were my friends. That's who I hung out with all the time.
And it must have changed you, all that moving. I mean, you must have developed some survival skills from it, or social skills, or...
The social skills, definitely, and later in life I appreciated moving around so much because, as you see, I'm very outgoing and I have a huge network of friends, and I don't think that probably would have happened had I not moved around so much. So I also got into acting, and I think joining a theater company or a theater in school was a great way to make friends because you're doing something together, you're interacting with people, and you learn to communicate with people. I have friends from all different backgrounds, all different nationalities, religious, non-religious, Muslim, Asian, everything.
Right.
And I think that the skills I have in life to do the things I do could never have come if I didn't move around a lot as a kid. So things work out, you know, there's always a blessing. There's a blessing in everything. You may not realize it today. You may fall down and break your leg and you get really pissed off and stuff like that, but you don't know why you broke your leg or what happens, and that may stop you from doing something that could have got you in trouble. So everything happens for a reason.
When you were a kid, what did you want to be when you grew up?
An actor.
Yeah. This
is the only thing I wanted to be. I know that's kind of strange, but that's what I wanted to be. So I did it, and I'm still doing it, and I don't know.
Were your parents very present in your life when you were a kid, or?
My parents were present. My parents are still married. They live in Florida, and you know, sometimes you don't realize how grateful you are to be in that type of environment. They're very supportive of me.
And where were you in the social pecking order in high school? Like, what clique were you with, if any?
I was the outsider because I went to so many high schools. You know, it's funny, I never went to a high school reunion. I don't really care.
Right.
You know, instead of getting a ring, I would have got a bracelet with all the names of the schools up and down my arm. You know, I didn't fit in because would just move. I went to so many different high schools, and you know, I used to tell.